Hello and welcome to another video. In this video, I will show you how to get the AI Village Editor from Firefly Studios to edit your AI villages for the game Stronghold Crusader. And I will show you also some basic tricks and how to test your AI villages. First, everything you need to know for the basics and how to use the editor you will find on this website from Firefly Studios. And you can just scroll down and everything is explained. You will also see these images displayed in the editor soon, when we will edit an example village. So you download this file, for example from Stronghold Heaven. You just click this download link and I will show you now how to open it. So you just unzip the zip data, and after that you click into the directory. It is named AIV Editor, and there you open village.exe. So now we are going to create a new village for Saladin. I already looked at some villages of Saladin and I also know how much production he has. If you want to create a village for a specified AI, you should already know how much production he has, how many types of stockpile he needs, like how many houses he uses for his economy, and so on and so forth. So you should know all about the AI you are going to modify already. Maybe you have even modified the AI beforehand with the community patch, and then you also know the parameters, so which units he uses and how big his economy is going to be. So the first step is going to be figuring out how his castle should look like. I want to also address some things. I mean, you can just search for the basics how to use the editor on the website, so I will not talk about that. But I will also give you some tips and tricks how to optimize your castle that you're building, because you don't want the AI to be just stupidly taking way too long to build up and not being in the game at all. So to start an AI from scratch, you can first, for example, build the castle in-game and make a screenshot after you flatten the buildings out with spacebar. Or you could just play around with the economy buildings like I'm doing right now inside the AI editor, but I already know that I will make just a basic box castle, because this is just an example. And if you have something like more artistic in mind, you can also start with the walls. There's like no end, so just experiment around as much as you want. And after you found something that you're into and that you really like, you can start building the castle from scratch again and placing it all in the right build order. So with the basic idea of your castle laid out, you also might want to control how fast your AI evolves inside of the game. So, and there come two big factors into play. First, the build order. So you always want to build the more important buildings faster. So there's the basic rule, place the stockpile so you can get his starting resources. Place the granary for the starting food, because else he will lose popularity. And then place the marketplace so you can do everything else, like buying wood for buildings, selling his extra resources that he doesn't need. And after that, everything else. But also, things that are very important are usually troop production, so give him a troop production building early, and also give him the houses as fast as possible, because he will check inside of his build order if he forgot something, and his houses he will not place in the beginning. He will only place as many houses as he needs at a time, and if they are further behind, he will also get supply blocked when he needs a new house, because he has to take all the steps from the start until he reaches a new house, and then he will place it. So always keep in mind, place the houses after your stockpile and your market and your granary. That's very important. After that, you can place troop production, armory, and the rest of your resource production buildings or food production buildings, whatever you want to do. Also, there is the rule, place the cheap buildings first. He might just be able to produce more. Also, that is just for the inns, so for beer production. Places breweries and some inns always according to the population he should have at that building time, so he has enough popularity to reach the +8 brewery bonus, if you want that for your AI. If your AI uses raid catapults to shoot at the enemy castle at random, you also need to give him some space next to his engineer's guild and try to place the engineer's guild outside of his castle walls, so his build up catapults and fire ballistas that he will harass the enemy with are not stuck inside of his castle. The second important factor is to take as few building steps as possible. I mean, you can also make your AI slower, then you can take more. But to take as few as possible, you always want your walls and your moat and your pitch to be placed in as few building steps as possible. And for that you can, for example, lay out some edges with your buildings, or like I do with killing pits here, to place the wall in one chunk, even if it's over the edge. And also for that, you can do round shapes, you can do edge shapes, just experiment with it around. You can also put in some malls, so just put in some buildings somewhere, then place your moat, and then there will be a hole inside. You can always delete like wall things later, so you don't need to think about putting too much. There's always the possibility to delete it later and he will still put it in one step. The next thing is he will have at least 50 starting stone. So if you want your castle set up fast, you might want to place buildings in a total value of 15 stone first before you set your walls up. Because he will actually cheat his walls if he has no stone, so he doesn't require stone for that. But he might use the stone for the walls if you set the walls first. That's why I recommend placing a tower and a gate to access the tower first and then placing the wall. You can always place the wall first and after that place the gate on top of it. That way he will only build the wall in one step, and he doesn't require two steps for the wall from the left to the right side of the gate. For keeping the buildings in the right build order, you always use the slider on the top right, where you can switch between the steps. You can, for example, place the wall, then go back, place the gate before the wall, and then the wall will be built after the gate. Giving your AI the ability to enter its castle on multiple sides gives its survivability a big plus, because it can enter the castle on one side while it's sieged on the other one, and also doesn't hinder it from getting to its outer production buildings way more efficiently. To make your AI early game bulletproof, you might want to close the castle after some basic production, like food for example. And for that you just place one layer of wall, you don't need to make it bigger. Take as few building steps as possible. Also keep in mind, the earlier in the build order you set up a building, the faster he is going to replace that, in case it gets destroyed. Fast replacements for walls are very neat in case of a siege. So keep in mind placing some layer of wall early if you want to make your AI bulletproof. If your castle gets a moat, you might also want to place it very early on, because he can just take his digging units and start digging right away. It will fill up over time anyways, and that way he can start earlier. Usually the last buildings you set up are the most expensive ones. Just in case you make an apt, you might want to place the cathedral first, as he will spend all his money in his marketplace before setting up that cathedral. That's very important, and this is like the most important building for him. But as you place the expensive buildings last, also good or bad things you place even further, and if you want some delay, you can always put some pauses inside of the build path. But keep in mind, if he hasn't placed anything before that pause yet, so maybe if he doesn't have enough money, then he also might take a break and then start placing dead buildings again. So the pause might actually hinder him to place essential buildings that were placed before that pause. To make your castle fireproof, you always want to keep one pathway free to every building that exists and that is actually inflammable. So wells, for example, are not inflammable, but houses, good things, bad things, all the production buildings are inflammable. So keep one pathway free. If you have set up buildings diagonally, they are still keeping a pathway open in between. But as soon as you connect a wall diagonally to another wall, the wall is closed off. That actually also applies to your keep. Inflammable buildings that share edges with each other will get incinerated in one instance if one of them is set on fire. So avoid making two big blocks of inflammable buildings. The next thing I want to talk about is setting up your troops. Don't place troops where the AI is not able to set up its defenses. So for example, if you place the tower in your build process at the last step, don't set all the troops on that tower, because else they will just be on the ground in the meantime. You are also able to set up three of each tower siege engine. If you have installed the community patch, you are even able to set up five of each. You are also able to set up multiple siege engines on one tower, but that's an exploit. Only do it when you feel like the AI you are creating has no honor anyway. For a high troop protection, you can use another exploit. You can put high towers in front of lower towers or gateways and place your troops on the lower towers or gateways. That way they can shoot through the higher towers and be protected. This way you don't need shields on top of towers the way that players would protect the troops. If you're setting up oil engineers, you always have to have an open spot where they can throw the oil at, two tiles away from them. So if you, for example, put killing pits around your castle, make sure that where the oil engineer is standing, there are no killing pits where he is throwing the oil. If you set up ground siege engines, they are always opened in the same direction that your keep is, so make sure that there is enough space for the engineers to enter. Also, the AI might misplace ground siege engines by one tile, so just keep a little bit extra space when setting them up. When you've already placed your pitch, make sure not to place the siege engines on top of it. Also, leave two tiles to the pitch, so you're actually sure that the siege engines will not get inflamed when the pitch burns. Some things that I consider bugs in the AIV editor I want to tell you next. So the first thing is, if you place stairs, always drag out the sixth tile, else the first and the fifth tile will be placed in one step, and that's not possible for the AI. Then one of them is broken and the AI will not reach the wall. And the second thing that I know of is that if you drag out a multi-tile thing like the wall or the moat or the pitch outside of the outer edge of the building area, then you might be able to break the editor, then it will freeze and all the great work that you've just built will be lost because it will crash. So always keep in mind, don't cross the outer edge with something like the moat or the wall. When you're finished, you can use the F1 button to save your work. Give it some kind of name that you like. You can even name it like the castle you already want to replace it with, but I'd recommend giving it a new name. You can still rename it later. To test your castle in-game, you go to the villagers folder and copy the castle you just named to the AIV folder of your Stronghold Crusader. In this case, it's Stronghold Crusader Extreme from Steam folder, in my case. Then you delete all the other castles of that AI Lord and rename your castle to the first one of that AI Lord, so he will only build your castle. When you've done that, you can start up the game and test it out. Now that we're in the game, we will test the AI that we just built. We didn't build the AI, we just built the castle. But we will test that castle in a skirmish against the sheriff. The sheriff is also building very slowly, so we can show that we are at least faster than the sheriff with our castle. And also we will do 2000 starting gold on this map. I like this map for testing, it has enough space. If you want, you can use a map with less or more space, it depends on the AI that you're building. But in our case, we just built a generic box castle, so it should be fine on this map. You can see now that we have already built a tower and the gate. Those two come with the first 50 starting stone, as I mentioned. The walls are just cheated. The Saladin has a very big economy, and you can also see the more woodcutters he places, the faster he builds up his food production. Also, you can see I placed the bakeries in some kind of diagonal shape, so if they got incinerated at the start, they won't burn as a whole block, and it's easier to extinguish the flames. The things that I am looking out for when testing his economy is first if he has enough food production. So, for example, if his granary is going empty, then he probably has not enough food production. If he is building his inns fast enough to get the brewery bonus. If he stacks up some gold, or if he produces enough troops, so if he has enough houses to recruit things, and also if he is able to defend its castle a bit at the start. So if he has like a very rushy opponent, he should be able to at least hold it for some time. And if you're satisfied with the result, if your AI is attacking a little bit, then you can test more. You should test how you can demolish its castle, if it's even breakable, if the enemy AI will attack it properly. And if you're satisfied with that, I can recommend doing it with some starting troops. If you're satisfied with that, then you can like look for the bugs in your AIV file. So maybe you need to fix something, replace some buildings, put more houses, whatever. And then you can just upload it and show other people or play against it or do whatever you like with it. So the main purpose of this is just to replace the original castles with your own, or place a castle inside the game that is specified for a special map. In this case, we just played against two caliphs who also make their AIV castles from my files and have some different behavior. In the next video, I will talk about unofficial Stronghold Crusader patch and how to modify the AI characteristics. Here you can see the castle is breakable, and he first lost both two towers in the front. So after he loses these towers, his castle is breachable. Without that, I think there would be enough firepower to kill most of these Arabian swordsmen. Also, the first attempt didn't finish through because he had some fire throws at the backline. And then when the sheriff attacks, he actually manages to kill him. So thank you for watching my video. I hope you got some nice tips and tricks. As you can see, Saladin is still having a big economy. He's one of the AI lords with the biggest economies. He sets up a lot of food production buildings, which gives him a nice population. And with his fear factor, he is also strong because his troops will get extra strength. As you can see, we put enough good buildings for the 5 fear factor that you can check in the end screen. If not, check it in the game by clicking on the troop and seeing how much health points he has. Okay, thank you for watching. Leave a like, maybe subscribe, and see you soon in the upcoming contest. And don't forget to check out the links in the video description for related content.